Today I wanted to switch things up a little bit and talk about switching on the Rodecaster video, so you can do things like switch between this camera and this camera right here, or even this camera right here, and all of the fun things in between, if you can keep track of your different sources. And that's because when it comes to just basic switching, just going between different sources, there's not a lot of difference between the Rodecaster video and other switchers, like an A10 Mini or something along those lines. But when you start folding in everything else the Rodecaster video can do, scenes, overlays, video playback, that's when it gets a little more complex. But fortunately, if you just kind of take some time to break it down, it's actually quite simple. So this is the second in a series of short, digestible tutorials about the Rodecaster video, all designed to help you master the caster faster. I'm more proud of that than I should be. So here is my Rodecaster video, and the basic layout is quite simple. So on this bottom row here that has numbers on it, these are my sources. And up here right now, these are my scenes. But what you can see on those scene buttons changes depending on which of the modes that you're in on the Rodecaster video, because they do differ a little bit. The basics though, right here, I'm just in the basic switching mode. So if I press 1, it's going to bring up camera 1. If I press 2, it's going to bring camera 2. And 3 is going to bring camera 3. And these buttons up here have some pre-programmed scenes that I've made. So the first one is a little picture in picture. Then we've got, it could be me and another video source right here. We've got another video source. I don't have a fourth camera plugged in today, so that's where the fourth camera would be, plus these things here, or just some other picture in picture stuff. This one's kind of nifty actually for right now. So the way that I'm doing that is this top row right here. That's how I'm activating these scenes, is they're ones that I have created either on the Rodecaster video itself or in Rode Central, and I put them in these, you know, in these banks right here. Now there are two different ways to switch between your main sources on the Rodecaster video, Instant or Studio. Right now I'm on Instant, and basically what that means is when I press a button, the scene changes, right? that kind of makes sense. But there is another option that works a little more like a traditional broadcast environment. And so if I go into my settings here, I go into Video, I can then go over to Switching and go from Instant to Studio. We'll check that box. And now what that's gonna do, once we go back home here, is if I push this button, you're gonna notice now it just turns green, but it didn't actually switch. That just means it's the preview, this is the program, and then I have to actually press the cut button in order to switch to that scene. And now if I press 3, it's not going to go back. I have to press the cut button to go back to 3. And if you wanna use a transition, you can just press the auto button instead of the cut button, and that is then going to let an automatic transition happen between your two sources. So basically whatever's red is what's currently live, whatever's green is what's going to be next. So we could even go from here to this scene, we can transition to the scene, and now, there we go, which camera am I on? There we go, now we're in this scene over here. Personally for me, I like to keep the Rodecaster in instant mode because I'm usually a one-person show, and so not having to essentially push two buttons for every switch sort of works a little bit better. But if you're in more high pressure environments or more complex environments working with a team, it's a little more common to use that studio switching mode. And that's kind of what you'll find in bigger, more professional broadcast environments as well. And one thing you might notice if I go back to the Rodecaster video here is some of these are not lit up. If there's not a source connected, the button just stays dark. So I don't have a scene in letter E over here, and I don't have video sources 4, 5, or 6. 1, 2, 3, and 4 are my 4 HDMI sources. 5 and 6 can be USB sources if you have a compatible webcam. Right now what that means is a webcam that outputs uncompressed UVC video. It's not every webcam that does that. Hopefully compatibility will improve in the future, but that's why there are 6 sources even though you only have 4 HDMI inputs on the Rodecaster video. Now this top row is very contextual based on which mode you're in on the Rodecaster video, and that depends on these 4 buttons right here. So you have your media, your overlays, your multi-source, and your keying. For today, we're only gonna focus on these 2, media and overlays, because those are the ones most relevant to switching, or at least basic switching, and it's easy to remember because they just line up with this row right here. So it's almost like everything here is kind of related. What that means is if I press the media button, now this has changed. I'm still on source 3, I can still switch between sources 1 and 2, but now I have A and B lit up. If I click on overlays, I also have A and B lit up. And what this means is these are the buttons that I have something loaded into. Basically, in Rode Central, I've gone in and I've added either like a video clip for playback or a graphic to overlay. So, let's see, if this were, this is a Rodecaster video tutorial, but if this were a Final Cut Pro tutorial and I wanted to put this little Final Cut Pro icon here, or I wanted to put my name up on screen, some kind of overlay, or I wanted to maybe switch over to this camera here, which is my Sony FX3, and I can put a little graphic in the screen to let you know which camera I'm using. This is how I would overlay those graphics with the same switching that I've been using before. This is not the FX3. And that's what I mean by saying those buttons are contextual. So if we go back in here and we see our regular sources, if I press the overlay button, now we have A and B because those have graphics on them. And if I press that, it will just turn on those graphics. One of mine being currently a Final Cut Pro icon and the other being an FX3 icon. This can be any other kind of overlay graphic image that you want to include. Media, if I push that, it's a little bit different. This can be video clips. These can be video clips. So that can mean if you want to have like an intro for a stream or a show, or you want to play a pre-recorded clip, almost the same way that the Rodecaster Pro with audio lets you use the smart pads. I can show you over here, my Rodecaster Pro. I have the smart pads here. I can play audio and do things like that. It's very similar with the Rodecaster video. When you want to do media playback, you can kind of use these buttons in that same way. So what I have here are basically the intro and outro to my podcast. So what I can do then is, if I wanted to just do everything all in one with very little editing, I can press record on the Rodecaster video, and then I can play the podcast intro and then come to this scene here. So here we go. I'm already recording because I'm recording for this video. So I could press record, I'm recording, and now I can play this video. I think you should still be able to hear me, but this is, you know, the podcast intro. The logo will pop up. It's a video. It's an MP4 video. .mov files, not super friendly. So MP4 works really, really well with the Rodecaster video. And then when I'm done there, I can just switch back to my source right here. Talk, do my show, switch between my scenes, all that. And when I'm ready to end the show, say, thanks, have a great day. Thanks for watching all the things. Bye-bye. Then we've got the outro right there. And that's basically how that works. And that just changes depending on which mode I'm in. So the media button is lit up. My media pool, my media library is here. My overlay button is lit up. My overlays are here. If I press it again, now nothing is lit up, and these are just my scenes. Something else related to switching that's very important is you do have your four HDMI inputs, but you also have two HDMI outputs. And so if I go into my settings and I go into video, that's gonna let me choose what I want HDMI A and HDMI B to show. Currently, that can be a program or a multi-view. Program is whatever is live. It's just whatever the current source is, and multi-view is the screen that has all of your sources along with your program up at the top. A feature I would really love to see that I'm hoping comes in a future update is the ability to have just a source output. So that means you could do program, multi-view, or source, which basically means I could choose, you know, camera 3 is just always going out to one monitor no matter what is being selected. There's a lot of really useful reasons that you would want just to be able to output a single source instead of only program or multi-view. So hopefully that's something that could come in a future update. Feels like it could be relatively simple to me, but I'm also not a software person, so I don't know if that's simple or not. So it can take a little bit of time to practice being aware of what you have loaded in each thing. If you do have Rode Central up on a computer or a monitor near you, it's a little easier to see your media library to remember what is where. But that's the basics of switching and switching sources on the Rodecaster video. And speaking of video, thanks to everyone who helped make this video possible by supporting the channel. And if you wanted to learn more ways to master the caster faster, check out this awesomely useful playlist right here.